Military is on the dais, off the dais, research scholars, and my dear student friends. In fact, I am thrilled to be in the midst of three great scientists seated on the dais as an integral part of the National Conference on Innovations in Biotechnology. I'm a great scientist. I'm a scientist of pride and an able and noble son of this great nation, Bharat, Dr. Afroz Ahmed, member Narmada Control Authority, Environment and Rehabilitation, Ministry of Water Resources, Government of India, whose presence certainly will be a source and a force of inspiration to all assembled here for reaping the benefits of this conference intended for the meeting and mixing of the minds of the younger ones and the elder ones for the cause of science and technology, through which for the cause of humanity, particularly for the cause of the citizens of this country. And friends, Professor T.J. Pandian is one of the greatest scientists ever produced in India, and people like me expected that he will not stop with the Patnagar Award and move forward to win the Nobel Laureate. I think he will take it further forward and upward to see that some great works he has already done may be retuned and refined for the purpose of submitting that to get the Nobel Laureate, which will be the greatest, the most happiest day of this Madurai Kamaraj University and the great country. And I am certain that that will happen in the near future. And for which, if our revered professor is in need of any assistant from the Madurai Kamaraj University, the whole university is a laboratory, equipments and systems. I am ready to put at your disposal as the sustained Vice Chancellor of the Madurai Kamaraj University. And all the doors of the high-end equipments available in the centralized equipment chamber and the equipment which are available in the School of Biotechnology, School of Biological Sciences and School of Chemistry. Why not even the School of Physics will be put at your disposal when, as and when you need for further reference and further utilization. Sir, your presence matters a lot to make this national conference a big success. And Dr. Kalidas is one of the greatest scientists of this country and whose association with this university, particularly with the Department of Biotechnology, School of Biological Sciences, I am certain will bring a lot of new laurels and credits to all of you, having a commitment to take further forward the scientific research through our scientific laboratories in our university. And friends, I would also like to give my respect to Mrs. Afroz Ahmed, whom I have come to know. She is a very fine poetess, and her presence is also an inspiration for all of us. And on this occasion, I would like to congratulate all the teachers who played a nodal role in organizing this program, particularly the Professor Shankar, Professor Kanesh seated on the dais, and all other young scientists, Dr. Shakila and Dr. Varalakshmi, Dr. Ashok Kumar, Dr. Pandey, Dr. Chandrasekhar is here, and Special Officer Dr. Kumaresan is here, and all of this I recognize, and I want to place on record your contribution to the making of this seminar, which will be a grand success. See, I would like to share with you a few thoughts, not as a scientist, but as a sensible citizen with common sense. I would like to share with you that the tigers and lions are no more threat to our livelihood, no more threat to our health and happiness, because they are now confined to the jungles. But what exactly is the threat to us? The mosquitoes, the small mosquitoes. Okay, these small mosquitoes are able to, they are embowered, they are embowering themselves in such a way that they are able to creep into our bedrooms and able to disturb our sleep and give us viral diseases, deadly diseases. What is your reply to this? As scientists in the field of biotechnology, as scientists in the field of biological sciences, and cutting-edge research, particularly in the areas of biotechnological application, the research in this country is taking place, no doubt, in a bigger way, on a larger scale. But what is the need of the day is not only the scientists to go for areas of application, because in a, you know, note given to me by Dr. Ashok Kumar, it is rightly stated that the biotechnological contribution to the health care, to the drug industry, to the vaccine system and all, and also the agricultural sector is very tremendous. And more than us, a lot has been done in the Western world in the field of biotechnology. And we have to compare our scientific breakthrough with the scientific inventions, creations made by the scientists in the West and in the developed countries. And then only we will be in a position to know where we are lagging behind and in which direction we are to move forward and what is the destination. In science, there is no destination at all. There is only direction. Only when we have the devotion, only when we have the national spirit, only we have the desire for achieving something great in your life, in my life, and in our life, something great will happen through research. So therefore, any classroom teaching, any experiment in the laboratory shall be research-based, shall be issue-based, problem-based, shall be development-based, so that we will be in a position to apply our mind to those areas where mind application is the pressing need of the times, without which the great dream of the great president of India, Dr. Abdul Kalam ji, that India will become a developed nation by 2020 by utilizing the tremendous power lying unutilized among the vast section of the youth in this country, the youth power. What is a youth power? It is not the physical power. It is not the verbal power or the vocal power. And it is your power of imagination. It's your power of intuition. It's your power of innovation, a power of creation. and creation shall take place. Innovation shall take place and dissemination shall take place in the form of knowledge transfer and technology transfer from our laboratories to the field and factory, to the rural people. And therefore only, friends, with the help of the enthusiastic teachers in the School of Biotechnology, Biological Sciences and Chemistry, we have now adopted 21 schools through the 20 schools. In addition to the 400 schools, 400 villages adopted through 100 affiliated colleges of this university to plant saplings, to make the villages green, clean, help the villages to go in for Make in India project and program. And now the biggest program which we are planning to launch is to train 4,000 farmers in biopesticides making, where we will tell the world and tell the country that we are transferring technology to the farmers of this country, so that, you know, the health care, the medical applications, the biological medical applications which we contemplate in this seminar has already been initiated in this university. I initiated not as a scientist. I initiated as a citizen, having concern for, you know, the health and well-being of my countrymen. So every scientist, when you take up a piece of research, please mind it that you do this not for yourself. Why? That all the natural resources are not for nature itself. The cows give milk not for the cow, it is for us. There are rivers not for the rivers, for us. There are valleys, hills, forests, everything, it's all for us to enjoy. And when the cloud rains, it is not for the sake of cloud, it is not for the sake of the greedy, not only for the sake of the rich, but for the needy, it is given to everybody. So everything available in this country is for everybody. And this can be ensured only by the scientist. In this country, unfortunately, clash of interest in the social sector, clash of interest in the economic sector, clash of interest in the cultural sector, political sector and all. It's all because of the fact that something is scarce in some area, scarcity. The scarcity of employment, the scarcity of opportunity. And these scarcities can be addressed effectively only by scientific breakthroughs, only by scientific invention, only by technological upgradation and fine-tuning. And when the economy is broad-based, when the productivity is increased by the application of the biotechnology, when the health of every citizen in this country is further increased because of the applications of the biotechnology, certainly India will surely emerge as one of the superpowers in this world without further loss of time. And I am very happy to associate myself with this program. And my appeal to the young scientists, the young teachers here, and I am very, very happy with the young teachers in the School of Biotechnology. And they are showing enormous interest to do a piece of research that will be useful to society. So therefore, any research shall be productive. Any research shall lead to creativity. Any research shall lead to innovation. Research with result. And result for certain problems to be addressed, certain problems to be solved. And if the School of Biotechnology will come forward to pose a threat to the mosquitoes, now mosquitoes are threatening us. Can we threaten the mosquitoes without using much the chemically processed coil and all? the coil and oil, in the place of the coil, can we go for the oil using the neem tree products? So therefore, our plan to create a neem tree forest in this university in 200 acres is intended for, with 90,000 trees are intended for great research to happen in this university. And you may think that the Vice Chancellor is speaking out because of his ambition in his mind and all. And this ambition and aspiration certainly will fructify when the student community, the research community, take it up further forward to apply to or subject it to serious thinking for a serious research in this field. And with these few words, I again welcome all the dignitaries on the dais, off the dais, and all the participants on my behalf and on behalf of the Madurai Kamaraj University, apart from the School of Biotechnology. Because every school in the biotechnology is an integral part of the Madurai Kamaraj University. So therefore, the head is the university, and the every other schools are also head, but not head above the head, and head along with the head, so that there shall be horizontal development and vertical development, both the developments. The individual shall come forward to achieve, and the school shall also collectively come forward to achieve. That is the direction towards which I want to drive all the minds and all the schools and departments in this Madurai Kamaraj University to show greater achievements, higher achievements, and achievements which will have a sustained effort. Thank you all.